The Life of Tanya. Tanya is the leader of the Denali coven, which consists of Kate, Garrett, Carmen, Eleazar, and her deceased sister, Irina. Like the Cullen family, Tanya and her coven also live a vegetarian lifestyle, feeding on wild animal blood rather than human blood. Tanya initially had a crush on Edward Cullen, which is shown and described in Midnight Sun and Eclipse. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Tanya. Before we begin, we publish new content every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life. Tanya was born in ancient Slovakia. She was the first of Sasha's adoptive daughters. She was Sasha's biological great-niece, and when Sasha yearned for companionship, she chose Tanya to join her. Within her first century as a vampire, Sasha added two more vampires to their family, Kate and Irina. They've been close as a family since then. Since Tanya was closest to Sasha, she was impacted stronger than her sisters when Sasha's crime of creating an immortal child was revealed. She did not understand the reason behind Sasha's actions, but once the Volturi tested Tanya and her sister's innocence and they were spared execution, she did understand why her mother had kept it secret from them. Their mother's death left the sisters traumatized, and as a result, they were purists for vampire laws. The pain of loss and emptiness became unbearable for Tanya and her sisters, and they tried to fill it with a long line of flirtations, which were enough to frequently distract them from their loss. However, every man they courted ended in death due to their inability to resist their blood. This continuous act earned them the title Succubus, a demon who seduced men and lured them to their deaths. Over time, Tanya and her sisters began to feel remorse over these small losses. Tanya was the first to become sensitive. When the pain became unbearable, she gave up human men for a time, but the loneliness returned. Tanya then tried to think of a way to go back to her romantic pursuits without killing her human companions. After much thought, she decided it was the steady diet of human blood that made it difficult for her to resist the blood of specific humans she wished to spare. Eventually, she discovered that drinking animal blood took care of her nutritional needs without weakening her ability to resist human blood. She showed this method to her sisters, and in a few centuries they had perfected their vegetarianism. While mostly courting with humans, Tanya had also courted with male vampires, though she had never found her match. When she met Eleazar and Carmen, she was happy to explain her dietary choices. As the newcomers became closer and closer to Tanya and her sisters, Tanya naturally took her place as the leader of the family. She was delighted to meet the Cullen family and saw Carlisle as her peer in many ways. She was also intrigued by Edward Cullen, mostly because he showed no interest in her advances despite the fact that he had no partner. Tanya never gave up her light-hearted pursuit of Edward, which is one of the reasons the Cullens did not settle in Alaska with the Denalis. Twilight. Tanya is briefly mentioned in Twilight as part of the Denali coven when Carlisle explains to Laura their lifestyle choices and affiliations. Midnight Sun. In the leaked pages of Midnight Sun, Edward stays with Tanya and her family after he first met Bella and was tempted to feed on her blood by her mouth-watering scent. At first, Tanya misinterprets the visit, assuming that Edward returned her romantic feelings for him. Once she realizes that Edward does not share her feelings, Tanya is still a good friend to him, stating that she believes he would do the right thing, unaware of his true reasons for visiting, and encourages his return to Forks. New Moon. In New Moon, Bella mentions Tanya after an exchange with Edward in which he explained that Alice was trying to convince Jasper to visit the Denali clan after his attempted attack on Bella during her birthday party, and again during her conversation with Laura before his death, he having taken up residence with her family briefly. Eclipse. Bella finds out in Eclipse that Tanya was once interested in Edward, but that he refused her. Tanya and her family are later called upon by the Cullens to help in the fight against the newborn army created by Victoria. They agree to help on the condition that they are allowed to break the treaty and later fight the Lapush werewolves to avenge Laura's murder in Irina's favor. Carlisle refuses the condition, since Laura was about to kill Bella before the shapeshifters intervene, and the families part on less than amicable terms. Breaking Dawn. Tanya and the rest of the Denali coven attend Edward and Bella's wedding in Breaking Dawn. They apologize for not joining the Cullens in the fight against Victoria's newborn vampire army, claiming that as members of the family they shouldn't have refused. Tanya is thrilled to finally meet Bella, teasing Edward and complimenting him on his choice of bride. Months after the wedding, Tanya returns to Forks with her family on the request of Carlisle. Initially, she is reluctant to believe that Renesmee is not an immortal child and fears the Volturi's persecution. However, after Carmen allowed Renesmee to explain her story, she persuades Tanya and the others and they all accept the truth and choose to witness for the Cullens, and if necessary, fight the Volturi. Tanya insists that she and the rest of the Denali clan be considered cousins of the Cullens. She, like the other members of her coven, are intrigued and watch Bella train her mind and body while they wait for the Volturi to come. During the final confrontation against the Volturi, her sister Irina is killed by the Volturi for false testimony as a ploy by Caius to engage Tanya and Kate into attacking them. The ploy is unsuccessful since Carlisle and Edward, Emmett and Eleazar in the film, restrain Tanya while Garrett restrains Kate. Zafrina temporarily blinds both sisters to keep them from moving. While the Volturi Council decide the fate of the Cullens and the Witnesses, Tanya claims Caius as her opponent in revenge for her fallen sister. It never comes to a fight as Arrow decides that Renesmee is not a threat to their kind. In Alice's vision of the battle in which she shows the demise of the Volturi, Tanya is seen fighting many members of the Coven and their Witnesses alongside her family. She is shown to be a very capable fighter, gaining the upper hand against the vampires she fights against. When the leaders of the Volturi see their main weapons, Jane, Alec, Dimitri, and Felix, destroyed, they join the fight themselves. Caius runs towards Tanya and grabs her by the throat. Garrett joins in and kicks Caius toward Kate, who stuns him with her power. Tanya slowly and coldly walks over to Caius, clearly enjoying the revenge she is about to take on him. She proceeds to put her fingers into his mouth and tears his head off through the jaw. However, since the battle was a vision, the fight never happens and the Volturi live in peace. The Denalis then return home to mourn their lost sister, with their new member Garrett, who has declared his affections for Kate, with her returning them. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.